In this world full of possessions, everybody has forgotten that Earth is the only planet that exists life. All are busy in their life. They use the nature for various life purposes, but when it comes to take responsibility, nobody really cares. But still, there are some people who understand their duty towards environment. One of them is Jadhav Molai Peyang, the forest man of India. The journey of his as an environmentalist started here. At the age of 16, Jadhav saw hundreds of dead snakes, the victims on Mazauli Reserve, the world's largest river island located in the Brahmaputra River. He knew at such a young age that somebody had to do something. So in 1979, at the age of 16, he started planting a tree sapling in the barren soil. But now, over 40 years later, his forest covered 1,390 acres. Jadhav even left behind his formal education to give his all attention to the forest. The son of a buffalo trader, Jadhav grew up a poor farmer from a marginalized tribal community in Assam, India. Jadhav began by planting bamboo and then he moved on to other species. At first, planting trees was time-consuming until the trees started providing the seed themselves. As his forest grew dense, soon it was filled with hundreds of species of birds, with deers, rhinos and tigers, and even included a herd of elephants. Peyang's worst fear for his forest is deforestation for financial gain. He believes all species on this planet are animals, including humans, and humans don't realize that frugality and honoring nature is the key to our survival. To honor Jadhav for his environmental activism, the forest was named Molai after him. In 2015, Jadhav Molai Peyang was honored with Padma Shri. Now it's about the Environment Protection Act of 1986. In the wake of Bhopal gas tragedy, the Environment Protection Act 1986 was enacted under Article 253 of the Constitution of India. On November 19, 1986, the Environment Protection Act of 1986 came into force and was extended to the whole country. The Act comprises of 4 chapters and 26 sections pertaining to the notes and responsibilities of different government actors and agencies. The Environment Protection Act authorizes the central government to protect and improve the environmental quality, control and reduce pollution from all sources, and prohibit or restrict the setting or operation of any industrial facility on environmental growth. The main objective behind Environment Protection Act are to protect and improve the environment and environmental condition, to implement the decision made at United Nations Conference on Human Environment that was held in Stockholm in the year 1972, to take strict action against all those who harm the environment. At last, I want you all to remind that the same earth, the same environment, and the life are the same. So do not waste it, live it. Thank you.